Hello, hello. How are you, Jeff?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm
Hello.
fine. What about
Fine,
you?
excellent. Hi, Ariel. How are you?
Fine, fine. I'm fine. What about you?
I'm okay. Thank you. A little bit tired, but okay. I'm gonna take the attendance list, and after that, we are gonna start with our class, okay? Just give me a second. Hi, Luis. Wait. Hi. Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Excellent. I'm glad to hear that. Sorry, my internet is kind of slow. So please, guys, stay present or something if you hear your name. Okay. Okay, Luis.
Present.
Excellent. Ariel.
Present.
Excellent. William is here.
Good evening, teacher.
Good
Good
evening,
evening, classmate.
alumni.
Good evening, my friends.
You are so happy today.
Yes, I am so happy because I was took my dinner. Yes.
Excellent, excellent. Okay, we're gonna continue. Jeff?
I'm here.
Excellent. Saul is not here, right? Duvan?
I'm here.
Excellent. Emerson? Adonai.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, Francisco.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, I think you are just you. Okay, so I'm gonna share with you my screen sheet. My screen, sorry, I'm crazy. Please let me know if you can see it, okay? Today we're gonna have a speaking practice, so we're gonna stop if you have any problem with the sorry,
yes,
with some topics, okay? Just in that case. If not, we're gonna do it quickly. Okay, so remember, this is just a short review. I hope so. So can you please Duan, tell me what is the difference between several and a large amount of?
I think the several use only when I talk about plural.
Plurals or countable nouns.
In the account, a large amount of is countable.
Very good job. Excellent. And what's the meaning of countable noun, William? Hello. William, are you there? Can you talk?
Yes.
There
yes.
is Colin.
Because I can hear. Okay, and can you repeat that?
Yes,
question?
What's the meaning of countable noun?
That you can count an object. It's an object that you can count, like,
yes, easy.
Pencils. Let me see. Pencils, coins, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, that thing.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. So, Luis, what's the meaning of uncountables?
Uncountable is object when I don't have a countable.
You can count it. You can't.
Can't.
Okay, excellent. Yes, for example?
For example, the water in the ocean.
Mm-hmm. Or just the water, because you cannot count it.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Yes, tell me. What are you going to say?
Clouds in the... What do you say, cielo?
Sky?
Sky. Sky.
Sky, it's another uncountable now.
Sky.
Mm-hmm.
Heaven.
Sorry, I couldn't hear you, the one.
Sky or heaven.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh, heaven. Okay, thank you. Let me see. Diego, can you give me an example using very few? Dieguito, are you there?
For example, very few. There are very few pencils in the classroom.
Okay, easier example, okay?
No.
No?
It's a lot.
Very few, it's okay.
A much few.
Okay.
I understand. A much few, muy pocos. Yes.
Much few.
Yes, muy pocos.
Only English, please.
So. Is it okay like that? Or both? Are both correct? What do you think?
I think it's correct. Okay. My opinion.
Okay. Okay. Adonai says it's okay. What about the rest?
Teacher,
I think it's wrong.
Much we use in uncountable nouns.
Very good job. And pencils, is pencils countable or uncountable?
It's countable.
Countable. So
yeah.
Can we use much?
No.
No. Very good job. We cannot use much. Not like because it is countable or uncountable. I mean, yes, it is true, but it sounds weird. Very much few. If we say very few, it's okay. And if you see, we can use it. We can use very or both, or countables or and uncountables. So it's wrong.
Understand.
Because much, it's for uncountables, and also because it sounds weird, okay? So, thank you, guys. Do you have any doubt about this topic? No? If not, we can advance. Okay. So, the other topic, because we checked three topics this week. Well, this unit. So, Francisco, can you help me read?
Okay, teacher. There are. We use them to express the existence of something. There is a monkey. There are five monkeys. There are many monkeys.
Okay, existence.
Existence, okay.
Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
So, thank you. Francisco, what do you understand about this topic?
I think there, when you speak, sorry. When you speak about one thing, is there is, and when you speak related about more two things, you use there are. There I don't know. It's okay, teacher.
Yes, and it's okay. There is for singular. There are singular. For plural.
Yes.
Just speak. We use it more like to talk about the capacity to talk a language. Okay.
Okay.
So it's better if you say talk.
Talk.
When we talk about. Okay. And also the pronunciation of speak, okay? Do you have an E here, like a speak? Or just without the E?
I think a speak, or I don't know.
A speak or speak?
Speak.
Mm-hmm. Speak. Remember it, that you are not talking in Spanish. We talk very Salvadorian sometimes. And it's okay when you are talking or speaking Spanish. But if you aren't speaking in English, try to speak like in English. So, here is another classic structure. We don't say a structure. We say
structure.
Structure. With to get that sound, you don't have to open your mouth when you pronounce the S. Something. Structure. If you open your mouth, it gonna sound like a structure. Structure. Did you notice the difference? So, yes, it is correct. It's basically that. Singular, plural. Saul, can you give me an example?
There are many trees in the woods.
Many
trees.
Trees? Mm-hmm.
In the woods.
Can you type the word that you want to say? Like that in the word. That's the word. Saul? Yes? No? Ah.
Words. The words I type in the chat. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
Implicit, yes. Yes, it is. It could be. Okay. So is your example okay, talking about the structure? Yes or no?
I think that is correct.
Why do you think that?
I think that is correct. But there are many
trees
in the world, in the walls,
in the woods,
in the woods,
okay. The woods.
Excellent.
In the land, in the land.
Mm-hmm. It could be also. Okay, thank you. Let me see. Ariel, help me read, please.
For many, we use how many for countable nouns. Examples, how many brothers do you have? How many t-shirts can I buy? How many colors are in the rainbow?
Okay, excellent. What is the pronunciation of that word?
Many.
Many?
Many.
Or money?
Many.
Many, very good job. Mm-hmm. If you say money, you are saying another. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So what did you understand about this topic? About this particular, how many?
When do we use it? We use many for things you can count. For example, mm-hmm. pencils, books.
Uh-huh. Could you give me an example?
Cars. How many houses are in the village?
Is that a question?
Mm-hmm.
Can you give me the correct intonation?
Sorry?
Can you give me or can you add the correct intonation?
How many cows are in the village?
This is a sentence.
On?
And the question mark?
Uh-huh, but I cannot add the question mark if you are not adding the correct intonation. I will give an example. How many t-shirts can I buy?
Okay. How many cows are in the village?
Excellent. Now it is a question. Is your question okay?
Let me see. I think yes.
Yes, because it is.
Because I am talking about plural.
Very good job. Excellent. Okay, so this is for countable nouns. So let me see. Jeff, what about how much? What's the difference between how much and how many?
We have to use how much when we are talking about something we can't count.
Excellent. Thank you, Jeff. Adonai, can you give me an example?
How many? I have an example for the other word.
How many? Sorry, could you repeat?
Yes, how many?
Yes, but can you repeat the sentence?
How many?
Uh-huh.
Is how many car are still running in the competition?
Oh. Is that a question?
Yes, is that this question.
Okay, can you give me the correct intonation?
For me?
Mm-hmm.
For me, how many cars are still running in the car? Yes.
I mean, the pronunciation, the intonation, like how many sand is on the beach? This is a question. If I say how many sands are on the beach, this is a sentence. Do you notice the pronunciation? When we ask a question,
Okay. Uh-huh. Yes. The form in the I say the question.
Uh-huh.
Okay. The intonation. How many cars are still running in the competition?
Competition. Very good job. Now, this is a question. Just remember that right now we are talking about how much. And you are using the question of how many. So can you give me another one using how much?
How much? Mm-hmm. How much shoe? No. How much?
You can do it.
How much? How much? That is not countable.
Mm-hmm. Uncountable.
How much water are the beach?
Okay, is it a question?
Yes.
Can't you give me the correct intonation?
How many water in the beach?
How many?
How much water are in the beach?
Okay.
The how say mar?
Sea.
Sea, yes. Sea, in the sea. Yeah.
In
the sea?
Okay.
In the sea.
Is that example okay?
No, can't use R.
Very good job. So now we are gonna fix it. How can I fix it? Hello?
Is how much water is in the sea?
Very good job. Excellent. So, any questions about, I turn off my camera because my connection is bad. Can you please tell me if you have any doubt? Do you?
Teacher, can't see you.
Yes, you cannot see me because I turn off my camera because my connection is unsustainable.
Yes, understand. Okay.
So, everything clear?
Everything clear.
Everything clear.
Are you ready to practice, guys?
Go to the practice.
Okay, excellent. So this is your practice, okay?
Let's do it.
Excellent. You are going to plan a trip, but some of you want to go to United States and the rest of you want to travel in the same country, so in El Salvador. So group one, which will be in room one, because you are gonna be in breakout rooms, search for a presentation or images you create a presentation, a PPT, talking about the United States. All of you have to participate using their E's, their R's. You have to talk about as much interesting things that you can do in the United States or in El Salvador. Any doubt?
Clear.
Any doubt?
Okay. All of you have to participate. Okay. Okay, guys. Room one, Adonai, Ariel, Diego, Duban, and Francisco. So you will be Team United States.
Yeah.
Okay, Adonai, Ariel, Diego, Duban, and Francisco. The others, Jefferson, Luis, Saul, and William, will be group two. That means Team El Salvador. Go ahead, please.
You can create with there is and there are.
I think we can use there are or there is, but can say the all the explanation, the other explanation.
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes, Toby.
We have to make a presentation, true?
Yes, just add images. Or if you if you find an interesting video, it's okay.
Okay.
It is that you have to win, so remember it.
Okay.
Teacher, only use the sentence, there are, is it, there are.
No, I mean, you have a lot of vocabulary to use, but the idea is that you use quantifiers, there is, there are, and also you know, how much you can ask another one, like, oh, Francisco, ask Duan, how many interesting things are in United States? You know, you can have like a conversation, make it interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But try to use it. But try to use it. Try to use quantifiers and countables and uncountables nouns.
I think
many people. We,
I think we should travel to USA because there are many parks and mountains and mountains. Yes.
Yes, guys, just remember that we are gonna prepare our presentation here and then we share it in the main session, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Got it.
I got it.
Got it.
I'm on it.
I think some of
In English.
Yes, a lot of immigrants, a lot of immigrants.
Aha, cabal.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was trying to say.
Okay.
Try to speak in English, please.
Okay, teachers. Well, the other was the gastronomy of the country. You can eat different kinds of, okay, of dishes, like pupusas.
Yes. Chicken pupusas.
Chicken pupusas. And the pupusa loca also.
The crazy pupusa.
The crazy pupusa. And the color pupusa. okay, another reason travel in El Salvador is the most better travel to USA because in El Salvador I don't know.
What is the name of the park of the La Libertad?
It's a
Sunset front, Park.
Sunset Park.
Sunset Park.
In general, Surf City in El Salvador is the best place to the surfing because we have the Surf City.
Best place to surf. So,
there are
Surf City is only part of the side that
is them. Damn.
Another, let me see. A good place to hike.
We have a
sky maybe.
Of purple and gold, yes, bro.
There is a lot of beautiful landscapes. There is a lot.
Yes, it's amazing.
Sunset landscapes. No, me faltó un N. Like that.
That is a lot beautiful landscape.
Yes.
Landscapes. We have the lake of Ilopan.
Yeah, guys, you can also search for videos. If you don't want to add images to the PPT, you can search for a video, an interesting video or something like that.
Okay.
You have to add images in a PPT to like defend your country, you know?
I didn't know.
I mentioned it. But don't worry, you just can pick some images on Google. So don't worry, it will be easy. You can also use paint.
Dibujemos la tepalita.
I don't hear
Okay, was someone doing the PPT or nobody was doing that?
I
don't I'm the cell phone.
Okay, okay. I will do it. I will do it, don't worry. I will share my screen so you can see.
We can use
image. What is the PPT?
I will picture. Do it. We have okay, to do it. Brrr.
Brrr. I get
real till I die.
What is your level in Multiversus?
I do not play Multiversus. I just download it, but I didn't play it. Yeah.
I think.
I'm sorry.
I just played it once.
But you think I was playing League of Legends. Before entering
what is
the
your
class.
Division? Noob.
I'm master.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm master. but I'm flex. Okay.
Master yeah, in flex is iron.
No, it's not bad. I do not play a solo queue because it's boring for me because I just play with friends, so that's why I play flex.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay. How beautiful. Yes, for the one who doesn't know what is sightseeing is turisteando. Or turisteando.
Traveling.
Okay.
Sightseeing. The beautiful landscapes. This image is low quality, but I don't know. I do not care. It's okay. I think I live near of this, but I'm not sure. Okay, so
I can see my house. What is landscape?
Landscape is como
paisaje.
Ajá, cabal, cabal. Okay. Exactly correct. It's cheaper.
Very good.
Dollars.
Bitcoin.
Yes, we have Bitcoin City. It's cheaper.
Dollar de uno. Okay.
Now the food.
What else? What? Food.
Oh, yes. Wow.
Gastronomy.
Super delicious.
Food.
Gastronomy.
Yes.
Super delicious food.
Okay, crazy food, crazy pupusa.
Yeah, pupusa. Yes. Like it.
Another is
the breed kill kids of Macaneño. La Tolchu.
Children killer.
Children killer.
The killer kills.
Remember that all of you have to participate in the main session. So please, try to practice what are you going to say.
¿Cuántos somos? Una falta para hablar todo.
Yes.
Yes, yes. Okay. Surf City.
Surf,
best place yes, to
surf city and Central Park.
Plane surf.
Como?
Best place. See. Best place.
The prime to, of the Pacific.
Best place surfing. To visit. Or to surf.
To surfing. To surfing.
Best wave. Best waves.
Best waves to surfing. Yes.
To surf.
Termo del Río.
Waves.
No lo encuentro.
In the...
In English.
Ah, yes.
We got it.
Hey, la manita de chilling.
Chilling hand.
The chill.
No, there is no hands.
Wait.
This meeting is being recorded.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay, guys, are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
So.
So?
Yes,
why? Were you?
No, we are ready all time.
I'm ready.
Just joking.
Okay, so room one will be the first one. If you are ready, just remember, all of you have to participate. Please speak aloud, because if not, I cannot hear you. And also, the other one I will tell you after that. I will give you feedback. So I am going to be taking notes. That's why I am going to be with my camera off. Okay. Okay. So if you are ready, you can also share screen, guys. It's okay.
Yeah, Ariel, share the screen.
Wait, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, I'm a star teacher.
Good night, teacher and classmate. Today I'm going to talk about Getaway Arch. It's a very nice place to spend with the family. It also has many buildings and a beautiful landscape. And also you can enjoy with your friends and try to do any kind of sports and try to learn more about their culture and their food. That's all.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good night. I'm going to talk about the Golden Gate Bridge. This bridge is interesting because it's a symbol of power of the and the progress of the United States. His land is
2,730 meters, and his height is 270 meters, and was his construction was in 1937, and I think it could be a good place for visit, and maybe because it have a good view from the bridge. That's all. The next one, this one.
Good night, teacher. Good night, classmate. That is my opportunity. I speak. I talk about to statutory liberty. There are beautiful park and there is a statue of liberty. In this country, there is a social security. We can discover so place cute. The next picture.
Yes. Okay. In the United States, you can visit a National Mall in Washington, D.C. There are some landscapes about memorial parks and different and extensive green areas. There is a beautiful monument called the Lincoln Memorial. And you can see in this image in the vertical monument, and also there is an historical national monument that people visit all of time, and it is the Capitol. The next one.
Who's next?
Duban, I think.
No.
I think nobody chose this one. Then this one?
No, I talk about to Grand Canyon.
Okay, Grand Canyon.
Okay. Hi, good night, all the classmates. At night, I'm going to talk about the Grand Canyon. In my opinion, I think it's better to travel the United States because have more places to you can visit. For example, Grand Canyon. Grand Canyon is located in Utah, Nevada. It's a good place to visit. The Grand Canyon have a width 16 kilometers. The water is very hot. You need to buy water, I think. There are many mountains of the um, I don't know, remember, say tierra in English.
Land, or are you talking about in general?
Rock,
like...
rock. It's rock.
Okay.
Montes of rock. Many mountains of rock. I think it's a good place to visit to with your family. Is that all, teacher?
Okay, excellent. So if group two is ready, you can do it.
We're always ready. We're born ready.
Excellent. That's the attitude. So go ahead.
Can you guys see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Good night, classmates, teacher. Today we're talking about doing sightseeing in El Salvador and why it's better to do it here and not in the United States.
Let's go, Saul. Go ahead, Saul.
Okay, sorry. I talk about the better reason if to travel in the Salvador is it is a little country. You can stay in the, for example, in the Santa Ana in the morning. In the afternoon, you can stay in the La Union. You can have visit to places or many places in the same day. It's all.
Okay. It's cheaper. It's cheaper to go to United States and do sightseeing. You are here in El Salvador, you don't have to spend money on like on a flight to go to another place. And also there is a lot of shops that can give you like an offer or a discount if you paid in Bitcoin, because it's the new coin here. And also you can still pay with dollar. And it's really cheaper to go and eat in a expensive restaurant, because what is expensive here is the normal price in the United States. I don't know if you can get me, but that's one reason.
Now the gastronomy. Good evening, classmate, teacher. I'm going to talk about the gastronomy of the country. Well, why the food of here is very delicious, because it's something unique that you can taste in another country. Also, we have la pupusa loca, the panes de niños, and also the pupusas you can eat in literally all the country, because there are much restaurants with that food, and there are different kind of food like atol chuco, sometimes con pollo, and there are a lot of food that it's, well, you need to travel here to taste all of it. Thank you.
Okay. One of the reasons traveling to El Salvador is better than traveling to the United States is because of these its waves. In this country are the best waves in the world, according to many people. And that's all. Have a good night. Thank you.
Oh, chill, the end.
Imagination.
That's the end of our presentation. I hope you all guys like it. And thanks for your attention. I appreciate that.
Okay, it was very nice.
By the way, I want to try Mataniños. It's very interesting.
Yes, they are very delicious, the children killers.
I liked that you don't change it for Mataniños. You don't change Mataniños for
children killer.
Children killer.
Children murder.
I think Mataniños, it's okay because they are, it is a very Salvadorian dish. So I think it's okay if you use that word. Just I think I will have some problems with the with YouTube because this video will be on YouTube, and maybe if you say that word, it's like my goodness, what are you saying? So
next time I visit Salvador, I want to try it.
Yes. Okay, guys. So quickly, I'm gonna give you some feedback. Just the pronunciation. Mostly, you have some problems with the pronunciation. Okay. So just we're gonna fix that, and after that, you can leave the meeting. So we have a problem here with your pronunciation with the T. And remember that you are not talking Spanish. If we are Spanish people, we cannot continue because we are not speaking in English, in Spanish. We cannot pronounce the same words in the same way. For example, today. What's that, guys? Today. Do you notice the difference? It's a little bit funny, right? But it's
today.
Today, we are going to. And that's something beautiful in Spanish, but in English, that sounds bad. So try to put the T, it's like, I would say golpe.
More sexy.
I don't know if it is more sexy. It is sexier, but... But I think it's better if you say today, because you are not talking Spanish, you are talking in English, okay? Also, that's not a problem of the pronunciation, but what do you think? Is that correct? Must better?
It's incorrect, I think.
But why?
Because must is big. And very is big, and you have the big sentence.
So the problem is not in that. Much better. Okay, much better. It's okay. And what about more better?
More better is wrong. Más mejor. It's like más mejor.
Excellent. So I prefer to say better because you have the comparative here. If you say much better, it's okay. I mean, in English, it's okay. But you, because you are, you know, Spanish, maybe it can sound for you a little bit bad. So if you want to say just better, it's okay. Okay? But much better, it's okay. And let me see. What about the third... word. What's the pronunciation?
You.
Excellent. If it's better if you say you. We don't pronounce like you. You are. We don't say like that. We say you. Okay. So if you have a Y, you are gonna use it like using the I in most of the cases, okay? Like yellow, okay? Also, the same problem. What about this one? Sports or sports?
Sports.
You don't need to open your mouth. Sports.
Sports.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
Like a snake.
And I think that the other one is just construction, like construction. And the last one, this one, what do you think about this one? What's the pronunciation of this one?
There.
Mm-hmm.
There.
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 Okay.
There are.
There. Pay attention on what you're saying, okay?
There.
Very good job. Okay, guys. Any doubt, any question?
No, teacher.
No, teacher. Thank you.
Okay, excellent, guys. So we're going to finish our class.